Chew, which is considered to be one of the oldest restaurants, Chinese restaurants in Calcutta. It's about 80 or 90 years old. It's quite noisy out there because it's very, very bustling. But we are going to go up and eat and eat a lot of food. I've got a couple of friends with me, so you're going to see this in a bit.
Chinese community in Calcutta. This is supposed to be the oldest Chinese joint.
And oldest would be how many years?
Around,
any idea?
90, close to 90.
And you're saying that maybe Chungwa?
Maybe Chungwa. So I heard that Chungwa was one of the inns where the Chinese travelers used to come and stay on the first floor, and then that the ground floor was their kitchen. And they came here to start their tanneries and dentistry and all those kind of people. They when they first moved here, that was the place they used to stay and they used to eat, which really probably wasn't an eatery at that time, but certainly was a kitchen.
But Chung was also next door only, right?
Chung was very close.
Near ABP.
Maybe it was the BNB that time. So.
Maybe it was the Airbnb on that topic.
What sort of food can they
cook? Simple homestyle food. And the dishes they are famous for, the Josephine noodles or rice and chimney soup, they are okay-ish. Like, we can get better stuff than this place in Calcutta. But what they do better is the steamed fish, the sui mai, of course the roast chili pop is brilliant.
And that's what you've ordered?
Yes. So they make it with lesser ingredient. And they don't make it like a curry, with sauce and everything.
Kaniska, you've been around a bit across the world and you've had Chinese food. You've eaten here as well. What are your sort of point of view on the food?
No, so I think our Uber driver cracked it when he said it's all about tradition. So people come here because they've heard this name a lot, and it's comfort food at the end of the day, like you rightly say. The food, it's not edgy food, it's not food that pushes the envelope, it's not food that gives you an unfamiliar palate. It's food that you're used to. It's still that chow mein, it's still that noodles, it's still that roast chili pop, all the chili chicken, or that fish, which is something that you're used to. One of the first ones to start this, yes. But do I come here for excellence in food? Unlikely. I come here for a hit of tradition, for a hit of nostalgia. I used to walk around the corner, used to walk down here for some lunch every once in a while. That's what I come here for.
The food is so good that I had to stop the boys and said, stop a bit, we need to shoot this video. You know, when I've heard things about YouTube, I've had various things said. Some like it, some don't. Even Indrajit said it could be a bit inconsistent. But what he says is you should know what to order right. And between Indrajit and Kaniska, we couldn't have ordered better. We started with the sui mai. And as you can see, we've almost finished this. So I guarded this sui mai for you. When Indrajit ordered this, I was saying, why has he ordered a sui mai? Because I've had so many sui mai all over the world, and which is this tight, potli like dumpling with a little cover on the base. This is very different. This is almost like that Bombay ka corn puff ka sort of thing which they do, but with, of course, a flour coating. And inside it's minced chicken and prawn. And I can't tell you how flavorful it is. Like, there's a slight tartness to this, a bit of chili, which is what Chinese food is all about. Like the the flavors coming through beautifully, and no chopsticks here, thankfully. And you know what? I've been using my hands to eat these. Then the mains came. You've seen the pictures, and we've almost finished, and we're going to finish the steamed fish. It's Kolkata, so therefore it's bhetki. I must say it's one of the best steamed fish I've had, and I've had quite a few all over the world. One of the best renditions of fish bhetki I've had. See how succulent, how well it was steamed. And sometimes bhetki, if it's not fresh, and especially if not in a fish cutlet sort of thing with a lot of spices, can be a bit of turn off. This is just brilliant, slight gingery flavors to it, in the sauce, and a bit of scallions and green chilies and onion. Which is what I call for the fried rice for this. And you can call it anything. We can call it mixed fried rice, we can call it the pati fried rice. It's the fried rice we've grown up on. Beautifully combines with the fish. We didn't go for the famous Josephine noodles here. Instead, we went for the pan-fried noodles mixed again. It's a sort of Cantonese dish made with a bit of bone stock broth. Very well. It went with the roast pork here. And so it's slices of pork, some belly pieces, some not.
with lot of green chilies, which is very typical of Calcutta Chinese. Long sliced onion as well. You know, bit of the natural juices of the meat which is here. And you know, this again combines so wonderfully with the noodles. So you know, like they say, in Josephine or rather in Eau Chew, you should know what to order. And you can try out various things, but this is what I recommend, because everything we ate today was very good. The sui mai and the steamed fish, these are things which I'm told you should call in advance and order, because it's not always there. But what you can always depend on is the fried rice, you can depend on the pan fried noodles and the roast pork as well. So I had sort of given up on Calcutta Chinese of late. I was not too fond of what I've eaten. Though I've grown up on this, but you know, having traveled and tried Chinese all over, sometimes I felt that, you know, the food here is a bit, at times, a bit oversalted, a bit too fried, a bit too spicy. But I think with what I've had in Eau Chew again, I think my faith in Calcutta Chinese has come back. They've been in the business for 80 or 90 years, I'm told, and it shows. And now, guys, thank you. You can eat.
Okay.